target name withdraws, you can hurt the virus as much as if you target the virus. So then the possibility that you have in order to develop antivirus will increase. Because not only targeting the virus, but now you can also target the cellular proteins that are important for the virus. Of course, some of these proteins cannot be targeted because they are also essential for the cell. But there is a subgroup of protein that we don't know yet. So we hope this subgroup exists that will be non-essential for the cell and will be essential for the body. And that's the idea, to identify these proteins and then to develop drugs. So what I'm going to talk about today is one of these proteins that we were best likely to identify. I identified a protein in 2006. And right now, I didn't make that, but right now there is a drug that is in clinical study against that protein. And that drug, I want to show some data about that, is a very effective drug, looks like it. So that means that in theory we can identify these parts. It's a matter of looking for them. So the problem about HIV, and that's why I am very interested in this one, is a big health problem. It's probably the most important health problem that we have right now. So around 25 million people have died from AIDS, and about 33 million people are currently infected with HIV. If you look at this number here, it's amazing. Around 7,000 new infections per day. Per day, 7,000 new infections per day. So as you've seen today, 7,000 people, you have, right? I'm sure you haven't seen 7,000 people. But that's a statistic. It's an indicator that 7,000 people per day get infected with HIV. It's a huge problem, it's a big, big problem. And then if you look at the distribution of HIV in the world, of the people that are infected in the world, the majority of these persons live here in the Sub-Saharan.